You can stay in this cabin and fight it out, or face the men who are waiting to lynch you. Either way, it's a poor choice.
Have Gun, Will Travel. Starring Mr. John Daner as Paladin. San Francisco, 1875. The Carlton Hotel, headquarters of the man called Paladin.
Oh, good morning, Mr. Wong.
Oh, Mr. Tag. Good morning.
Yes. Please, Miss Wong, at the Carlton Hotel, you speak to me as, hey, boy. Everyone does.
Oh, yes. I forget. Good morning, hey, boy.
Good morning. You did not meet Mr. Paladin before he left?
No. The lady in charge was showing me what the new duties would be this morning. He left very early.
Oh, yes. But in 2 days, he'll return. Then I introduce you to my very good friend.
That would be very great pleasure.
Oh, yes. No.
Something is wrong?
Oh, when you make Mr. Paladin's bed, you make it West Point style.
West Point? I don't know what you mean, West Point.
Oh, I assure you. Oh, hey, Mr. Paladin, very particular about bed made army way.
Mr. Paladin in the army?
Oh, no. But he was several years ago.
Oh, yes.
He said it is only proper way to make bed.
Oh,
no. You do not tuck your blanket on the corner like this. Oh, no. You watch careful now.
Right.
First, you fold on the bottom side like this.
Yes.
Then you hold up the end of the blanket and tuck on the corner like this.
Oh, yes.
Now, drop blanket and tuck on the whole side.
Very smooth, my Mr. Chang.
Yes, hey, boy.
Ah, yes. Hey, boy. May I please try other side?
Okay.
Mr. Paladin teaches you to make bed like this?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes.
I learned many things from Mr. Paladin.
Oh. While I work at Carlton Hotel, perhaps you teach me many things?
Oh, yes. It would be a great pleasure.
The job was finished. The man who had hired me in Salinas had given me an extra $100 to prove that he was pleased, and I was on my way back to San Francisco. It was good to be alone on horseback. As I rode through the verdant coastal valley, I was reminded of Illinois, as I had known it when I was younger. In my imagination, I could see myself riding along on my father's farm, everything very green and sparkling, wonderfully new. Hours became minutes. Then suddenly, I realized it was almost sundown, and I was lost. I had apparently taken the wrong turn at a fork a few miles back. My plans had been to stay overnight in Morgan Hill with an old friend, but now I'd have to bed down on the trail after I found water. While I was looking for a stream, I saw some smoke circling over the treetops a couple of hundred yards ahead. A closer look revealed a small cabin nestled in a grove of eucalyptus. Hey, easy, boy.
Don't come no closer. This is private property.
Well, hold your fire. I'm not trespassing.
This is my land. Strangers ain't welcome. How come you're nosing around here?
I was looking for a creek. My horse needs water.
People don't look for creeks in these parts.
Everybody around here as friendly as you?
Just be on your way, mister.
Look, I've been riding all day. If you look at my horse, you can tell he needs water. You got a well, I'd be willing to pay.
How much?
You tell me it's your water.
You willing to pay $2?
That's your price?
Let me see the money.
Here.
All right. Bring your head of water. Dismount and walk your horse up to that trough by the pump. I'll be right behind you with this rifle. All right, walk.
You're mighty free with that rifle.
There's been a lot of horse stealing lately.
You got a lot of horses?
A few out back. They're good ones. They're worth stealing. I don't take any chances.
I see.
A man don't just happen to wander onto my land. This ain't on the road to no place.
I wouldn't be here if I hadn't got lost. I was on my way to Morgan Hill.
You're better than 10 miles from Morgan Hill.
Huh. Not much water in the trough.
There's more when it's gone.
I'm afraid I won't have any luck picking up that trail before morning. It's going to be a dark night.
Dirk?
What is it, Agnes?
The supper's on the table.
I'll be in a minute.
What's he doing here?
Watering his horse.
Dirk, I heard the shooting. What was it?
Nothing.
Who's that man with you?
Stranger.
Is he staying for supper?
No.
I'll need more water.
Well, you just pump it yourself.
Dirk, why did you hit him?
I don't trust him.
You killed him.
He ain't dead.
He ain't moving. Why'd you do it?
I aim to find out who he is.
It looks like he's breathing.
He's breathing. There ought to be something in this wallet telling who he is. Here. Huh? You read the printing on this card.
I see. It says, have gun, will travel, wire Paladin, San Francisco. His name is Paladin.
And that card means he's a hired gun.
You don't think...
I might have known him come snooping around here near dark saying he's lost.
You think the ranchers hired him?
Yeah. Probably old Fred Mosley. I got more of his horses than any others.
Don't pay, really, Douglas.
What do you mean?
Always running, hiding, pretending. It don't amount to a thing. We could make a better living digging clams on the beach. Horse thieving don't amount to a thing, Dirk.
Now, don't start that again. You just get us ready to move out of here by sunup.
What are you going to do with him?
I don't know. I never killed a man before. It's... just might be the first time.
Somebody had exploded a stick of dynamite inside my head. I tried to reach up and stop the throbbing, but my hands wouldn't move. They were tied behind my back. I tried to move my legs, but I only felt the rope that was binding them together. Finally, when I was able to focus my eyes, I found I was lying on a bed in a corner of a cabin. In the middle of the room, there was a table with a dim lamp on it, and a woman, Agnes, was bending over a box, stuffing it with pots and pans. She must have heard me move because she looked up.
Oh. Finally woke up, huh?
Why did he hit me?
You can be thankful he didn't kill you.
Why would he want to kill me?
We're on to you, mister. Dirk thought you looked suspicious, and he was right. He found your card. We know you was hired by the ranchers to come after Dirk.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I suppose you deny your name's Paladin.
No. That's my name.
Well, don't be tricking me. You can be honest with me, because I saved your life. Dirk wanted to kill you, but I talked him out of it. You can thank me for that.
I'm grateful. I do thank you.
It ain't your skin I'm worried about. I'm just not going to have my husband start killing.
Well, why would the ranchers hire me to get Dirk?
There you go again.
Now, listen. I don't know who your husband is or what he's done. I was lost. The smoke from your cabin led me here. I wasn't hired by any ranchers. I don't know anybody this side of Morgan Hill. Now, believe me, I'm telling you the truth.
If you are, you wouldn't have to move on.
I'm telling you the truth.
You could stay here.
Dirk? Dirk?
Yeah?
Come in here.
You believe me?
Maybe I do.
I wasn't lying.
I'd like to believe you. Maybe because I'm tired of running. Maybe because I like this valley, this cabin. Seems like a home.
I told you to keep the door closed. What do you want?
He woke up.
Is that why you called me in here?
I was talking to him. I think you ought to hear what he's got to say.
We don't have time to prate with bounty hunters. I got the wagon hitched up. Are you done with the packing?
He says he wasn't hired by the ranchers.
He's been giving you some soft talk. You always was a sucker for soft talk.
I wasn't soft-talking your wife. The ranchers didn't hire me.
If he's telling the truth, we don't have to run.
I'm not taking any chance.
Dirk!
Douse the light. Get down on the floor.
Can you see anything?
No. No, it's pitch dark out there.
Come on out, Dirk. We know it's you that's been stealing our horses. Come on out.
That's Fred Mosley.
Gotta get me, Mosley. There's the answer to your soft-talking friend, Agnes.
Listen to me.
She was beginning to believe you. I was right. You was hired by the Mosley gang.
I don't know Mosley. I didn't know you were a horse thief.
You ain't even a good liar.
Look, if you'll untie me, I'll prove to you I'm not with those men. I'll help you out of here and see to it you get a fair trial. Otherwise, they'll hang you.
Dirk, maybe what he's saying...
He's tricking us again. Don't listen to him, Agnes. He led those men here. I should have killed you in the first place. And I'd shoot you now, but I got a better plan. Mosley!
Yeah?
I got your man tied up in here.
What man?
The man you hired to come after me.
We didn't hire him, man.
He says he was hired by you. His name's Paladin. I'm going to shoot him if you don't leave me be.
It won't work. You're wasting your breath trying to fool us, Dirk. If you don't come out, we'll burn you out.
You believe me now, Dirk?
Maybe he was telling the truth.
It don't matter now whether I believe you or not. They're going to burn the cabin.
Paladin, what would you do if we untied you?
Help to see that your husband doesn't get lynched.
Now, how can you do that? Well, there's at least three men out there, and they're not going to settle for anything less than a lynching. No matter what you or anybody else says to them. Besides, what do you care if I hang or not?
I believe in a fair trial. A man's guilty, it should be decided in the courtroom.
Trial or no trial, I'm going to hang.
At least you wouldn't hang tonight. You'll have a chance to hire a good lawyer.
Are you coming out, Dirk? Or do you want to stay in there and fly?
Paladin, how do you figure on getting me this fair trial you're talking about?
Give yourself up. Now, they'll take you nearby. I can follow you and surprise them before they get the rope around your neck. Agnes can go with me with a shotgun. With us undercover in the dark, the odds will be just about even.
All right. All right, maybe it'll work. But there's just one thing you didn't mention.
What's that?
Agnes will stay behind you all the way with that shotgun. And she'll shoot you if you don't do what you just now said.
Fair enough.
All right, Agnes. Untie.
Mosley didn't believe there was another man in the cabin. I hid behind the door, but they didn't bother to come inside. They were only interested in Dirk. Agnes stood outside until they were gone, and a few minutes later we were on horseback, following the sound of Mosley and his men.
Paladin?
Yeah?
I'm scared.
for yourself, for Dirk.
For Dirk.
Don't think about it.
Ain't no cause for me to hold a shotgun on you, is there?
No, no, there isn't.
I can feel it. You're different from most. You're clean. There ain't no pretending with you. I know that for sure now.
Hold up. I get down, we'll walk from here. Now follow me and be as quiet as you can.
Bring me up,
there they are. The quiet now. Come on.
Hang hat, that but you don't know for sure I'm the one who stole your horses. I didn't do it. You don't have no proof.
You're a fool. Think we didn't see our horses out back of your place without bringing on?
All right.
I bought those horses.
Let's stop here.
A man brought them by my place.
He already got the rope tied on his neck.
Yeah.
Swing the rope over there.
You're ready to slap the horse out from under him.
Hurry, Paladin.
Stay behind this rock. Keep the shotgun trained on Mosley, but don't shoot unless you have to.
Horse thieves don't get a trial.
I'm going to move up closer.
Stand over there by the horse, Tom. Get rid of her slapping when I...
Mosley!
Who's that?
I got four men with me, armed with shotguns. We say you're not going to hang Dirk.
Come on out here where I can see you.
Not likely.
Why do you want to stop a hanging? He's a horse thief.
Clear out, Mosley, before we start shooting.
How do I know if there's four of you?
Try us.
You don't leave me much choice, mister. You can't fight men we can't see. All right, Tom. You and Bill get on your horses.
Mosley, don't try anything.
We're leaving.
No, wait, Mosley, don't do it. Don't let her.
Oh, no!
Agnes, stay back there. Dirk. Dirk.
Paladin.
Can you hear me?
You cut him down in time, didn't you? He's all right. He ain't moving, but I know he's all right. Amy?
He's dead.
We didn't stop him, did we? Slapped that horse out from under Dirk right before our very eyes.
I'm sorry, Agnes.
You tried. That's all you could do.
You want to cry, Agnes? Go ahead. Did it help?
I don't want to cry. I knew it was going to happen one way or another. That's why I was scared. But it's all over now. I'm not scared anymore.
Travel. Created by Herb Meadow and Sam Rolfe, is produced and directed by Norman McDonald and stars John Daner as Paladin with Ben Wright as Hayboy. Tonight's story was written by Frank Michael. Featured in the cast were Vic Perrin, Gene Bates, Joseph Kearns, and Virginia Gregg. This is Hugh Douglas speaking. Join us again next week for Have Gun, Will Travel. Thank you.